Friends, I want to appeal to all of you, whether you are in India or abroad, anywhere. Humanity must express its concern about the plight of Rohingyas. We all should join what the United Nations High Commissioner for Human Rights has said and what the whole of human community is saying, including Desmond Tutu, Dalai Lama. We should all be concerned about the plight of Rohingyas. The government of India should not take a very partisan and uncompromising stand about the poor Rohingyas who have come over to India over a period of 2 to 3 years. They are being identified, they are being pushed back into Burma, where death is waiting for them, torture is waiting for them, mayhem is waiting for them. Aung San Suu Kyi, in spite of having received this Nobel Prize for Peace, has abdicated her moral responsibility to look into their plight and accommodate them in her own land. And she is responsible. But as long as she does not carry out her responsibility and assure full security with dignity to all these Rohingyas, whether Hindus, whether Muslims, we should provide all possible help to our suffering humanity. And on 2nd of October, which is Gandhiji's birthday, and the world over it is being celebrated as the World Non-Violence Day, I will be undertaking a fast for the whole day. And I'm glad to tell you that my dear friend, Rajendra Singhji, who is also known as Waterman, an expert on water problems, is also undertaking this fast. And P.V. Rajgopalji, a famous Gandhian, and Manohar Manavji from Bihar Chhapra, they've all agreed to undertake this fast for the whole day on 2nd October. And let us join hands, let us raise our voice. I'm glad to tell you that Varun Gandhi, who also happens to be a member of parliament from the BJP, the ruling dispensation, has also voiced his concern, come out with a statement on his tweets. And therefore, there must be many more, all across. And let us not dub Rohingya Muslims as terrorists and the Hindus who are trying to cross over as Sharanarthi or refugees. This distinction of Hindus and Muslims is something very, very disturbing. And I would urge the Home Minister of India, Rajnath Singh Ji, not to indulge in this type of communal categorization. Let us hope the Supreme Court of India will give us proper direction, and so that Government of India lives up to its great, glorious tradition. Whenever we have welcomed the Tamils from Sri Lanka, we have welcomed lakhs and lakhs of Tibetans from Tibet, the Buddhist. And we have similarly helped the Parsis when they came, and our friends from different countries, including Bangladesh. During that war, more than 10 million people crossed over into India, and they have been accommodated for a long, long time. Similarly, today, the situation calls for a deep human compassion for our Rohingya brothers and sisters. Let us not say that those children, small children, 1 day old, 5 day old, 10 day old, should they be considered terrorists? What sense of proportion has India's Home Minister Rajnath Singh Ji? Please look into their plight. Don't lose your all sense of proportion and just dub them, each one of them, as terrorists. And don't push them back. It will tarnish the image of the great name of our country, our civilization. And we will be accused of ethnic cleansing. We are helping the Myanmar government and military to indulge in this type of a genocide. We will be held responsible. And the pages of history will see the blot, Indian name in that black spot. Let us not do that. And I'm sure everybody will rise to the occasion. And 2nd October, we should all observe one day's fast as our solidarity, mark of solidarity for the suffering humanity of Rohingyas. Thank you very much.